Hi guys, and welcome to another WordPress tutorial. This is Jamie from System22 and WebDesignAndTechTips.com. Well, there's been a bit of a buzz going around about a new page building plugin called Elementor, so I thought I'd take this opportunity to just take a look at it and see if it's any good. I'm getting some very good feedback on it, so I thought I'd take a look for myself and share it with you. So I've just got a new install here of WordPress, this 2011 theme that comes default with it. I've called it Elementor, as you can see. So let's go ahead and add our Elementor plugin. So let's go down and go to plugins. Now Elementor's got a free and a paid version. I'm just going to have a look at the free version here today. I'm going to hit add new. I'm going to type Elementor. Okay, and there it is. So let's go ahead and install it. And I'm going to go and activate it. Great, and they've actually got a video here that we can watch to get started with it. Let's have a look around things that are in it. So here's where it's been installed. It's come up under my dashboard menu here. No templates there. Let's have a look at settings. Okay, and from what I understand, if we check the disable default colors here, that'll only use the colors that we've got on our theme that we've got installed, which is 2011. I don't want to do that. Default fonts. And again, this, it'll just, if you check this box, it's just going to use the fonts that are installed on your theme. Now, if you're using a great theme that you want to continue using just to use pages, probably a good idea to check those boxes. And there's a data tracking one here if you want to send some anonymous data to them so they can improve their product. Okay, style, let's have a look here. Okay, I see they got their default generic fonts here. Sans serif, I'm sure you can put in whatever you want. Content width, this is going to be the width of the page builder element itself. So 1140 is fairly standard. 960 used to be the standard, but it looks like you can change this to any custom that you want. Space between the widgets, 20 pics. Yeah. Till I do a bit of building, I'm probably not going to want to change that. I may want to change it at a later date. Yeah, and this says it's going to stretch widgets to the side of the body. That's fine. Page title. Okay, just want to select what kind of entry page title you want. A lot of times I'm going to turn that off. Tablet breakpoint. That is what size the screen shrinks down to before it puts in the tablet style. And here's the mobile breakpoint, which is fairly standard, 768. Again, when it gets down to 78 pixels, that's when things are going to collapse on top of each other for mobile styles. So this is looking pretty good. They've obviously put a lot of thought into this. Image lightbox, open up all image links in a lightbox. Well, don't know if I want that for all images. A lightbox, for those of you who don't know, when you've got an image there and you click on it, it opens in a larger, more high def image, or at least a larger image version of the one that you're seeing there in your thumbnail. So I'll leave that for the time being. I haven't made any changes here. Let's see what they've got in advance. Okay. CSS print method It's either going to create an external style sheet or inbound, which means, I'm guessing that means on page or inline CSS. Okay, so this is something you want to turn on and turn off if you've got a conflict, if something's happening. Editing handles. Okay, it's gonna, if you say show, it's gonna show little handles when hovering over elements that you want to edit. So I'll leave that in hidden. I haven't made any changes there. I mean, I flip between the two, but everything's the same, so I don't need to save anything. Role manager. I see. If you've got multiple people using your site here and they've got all their profiles, obviously if they're an administrator, they can use everything. If they're an editor, you can decide whether they can use this editor or not. If they're just an author, again, you can decide whether these people can or can't use this editor. That's kind of handy because some people, when they get access to the site and they want to do a little bit of work, if they don't know what they're doing, they can very easily mess things up. So that's quite good. You can control what your contributors are doing to your site there. Tools. Okay, regenerate files, that's kind of handy. It's got a library of things, so it syncs to its library on a daily basis. Or you can do it right here and make it sync. Debug bar. Okay. That's showing you any templates that you've got installed on a page, and you can disable it or enable it. I think disables the best. You're going to know if you've built that page, you'll know what you've got on there. But for somebody else that doesn't, if they enable that, that's going to tell them. That's pretty cool. Okay, replace URL. That's interesting. Okay, that is pretty handy. Normally, you're probably not going to need it. But if you've migrated a site, I imagine if you've migrated a site to a different URL or hosting, you can do this and make sure that all your old URLs are updated to a new one, which is good. I quite often use a plugin for that called Go Live after I've migrated a site, just to, because sometimes images will have the old media library URL. And with something like this, you can just go through them. Anyone's with the old URL, put your old URL in there and your new one here. Anything that's got that suffix right there is going to be changed to the new one. So that's pretty handy right there. Okay, version control. All right, a version control. Yeah. If you've got a certain version of it, 2.1.8, and suddenly things aren't working properly, you've had your site up, it's looking great, but you update it to the next version and suddenly your site's not looking good, looks like you can roll back to the previous install here. That's pretty handy, because sometimes when these companies bring out these updates and new packages, as I'm sure you all know with Apple phones and Windows operating systems, it will mess something else up that they haven't considered. So that's quite a handy little feature. Okay, I see maintenance mode, coming soon, maintenance. Got it. And it looks like they've got some templates here for your maintenance mode. So that's a handy little set of tools they've got here, system info. Okay. They're talking about my server. I've got it on my local host here, so that's just the info about where I've got it hosted. Getting started. Good, here's that little video again. That's fine. Knowledge base, it's probably their blog, I imagine. Yep, it's taking us away from the site here. And it's taking us to their page with some useful info here. That's great. Good. They haven't just left you out in the cold. Go Pro. Okay, so what's the... Oh, let's go custom fonts. What we've got here. Okay. This is asking you Go Pro to be able to do that. That's fine. And the GoPro button itself, hopefully it's going to tell us what you get extra. See how much the Pro version costs. One site $49, three sites $99. Well, that's like a developer license. I've got a developer license with my Divi, and it's been well worth my while. But I get all updates. But I'm sure if it's very good, these are going to be worthwhile. I think I'm going to try the free version before we do anything else. So there you have it. There's a quick overview. That's all I wanted to do today. And as you can see with the pro version here, you can load all these templates in. I'll bet there's probably templates for the non-pro version as well. But that's fine. I'm going to leave it here for today. In the next one, we'll start building with this thing and see what we can come up with. In fact, I'll do a whole website with it. From start to finish, and we'll see what happens. So there we are. I hope you've enjoyed that. If you have, please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. If you're interested in web development, take one of our courses below. We've got some great free courses. We've also got some premium courses down there with some huge discounts for our YouTube subscribers, so do take a look. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and webdesignandtechtips.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.